As she had concluded, her good mother had died some years before, blessing her absent children. My wife shed some tears, but was consoled by the certainty of her mother's eternal felicity and the hope of their meeting in futurity. One of her brothers was also dead. He had left a daughter, to whom my wife had always been attached, though she was very young when we left. Henrietta Bodmer was now 16, and, Mr. Horner assured us, a most amiable girl. My wife wished much to have her with us. Ernest would not leave Mr. Horner a moment, he was so delighted to meet with one so eminently skilful in his favorite science. Astronomy made them such friends that Mr. Horner petitioned me to allow him to take my son to Europe, promising to bring him back himself in a few years. This was a great trial to us, but I felt that his taste for science required a larger field than our island. His mother was reluctant to part with him, but consoled herself with the notion that he might bring his cousin Henrietta back with him. Many tears were shed at our parting. Indeed, the grief of his mother was so intense that my son seemed almost inclined to give up his inclination. But Mr. Horner made some observations about the transit of Venus, so interesting that Ernest could not resist. He left us, promising to bring us back everything we wished for. In the meantime, Captain Krusenstern left us a good supply of powder, provisions, seeds, and some capital tools, to the great delight of Fritz and Jack.